Hi there, this is Jacob, jacobleevideoproduction.com, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to adjust the camera settings of your Logitech webcam. Logitech is one of the most popular webcams. I'm using the C922 Pro, but the C920 is also very popular. I think it's under $50, and these are great for small businesses or entrepreneurs. The way you can use them for your business, you can do Facebook Live using your webcam. You can also do screen recording or record yourself for videos for your clients. And if you're doing Skype or FaceTime, you can do it using your webcam instead of, you know, the built-in one on your computer if it has one built in. Something like this will not only have better image, but it will also have better sound. So I'm going to open up the camera settings app. So I have camera settings open right now. I'll go into the different settings and you can kind of be adjusting these on the fly. If you're on a FaceTime call with someone, you can have this open and tweak it a little bit if you needed to. So image is standard. And if we change it to widescreen, that'll be the full widescreen zoomed all the way out image. And this is a 1920 by 1080 pixel. That's a high resolution camera. So this will be the very highest resolution on my recording. It made it go a little crazy there. But if we do standard, we have the option, it's a little more punched in by default, and we have the option to zoom it in. So this is, you know, the final image we're getting. Just know it's going to be lower resolution than that because the full size image is 1920 by 1080 pixels. However, if you're punched in like that, it's not going to be full resolution. So I often will do widescreen, it kind of depends, but you do want to make sure focus is set properly before widescreen, which means zooming in on it. So we'll get into the advanced tab and I'll start with focus. Autofocus, I just don't find it works very well. So if we're able to zoom in, I'm actually close enough that I can manually, you know, make sure that that's in focus. Now that I've set focus properly, if I wanted to do widescreen, I could switch to that, but the focus is set properly, if that makes sense. So often I find it's useful to zoom it in, focus, and then switch it to widescreen if I want to go that way. Brightness is how bright the camera is. Obviously, it's going to be electronically boosting the image, so that could introduce some noise or some softness. So if possible, if it's way too dark, try to get a little bit more light, especially if you know that it's fairly dark there. You want to, it gets really washed out when you bring it up a lot like that. And, you know, it starts clipping or the color detail goes away in the brighter parts as we get super bright. So you want to work with the brightness and contrast to make it kind of your liking, where it's not way too dark, but not too washed out. Now with the color intensity, we can change. Often this is called saturation. And we can adjust where we don't look like, you know, Smurfs or something, or way too colorful, but also don't look completely dead. So it's finding the right balance. And the white balance, this is blue light, orange light. It will set it automatically. Often I don't find it spot on. I wish they had one where you could adjust for pink versus green. Like right now it's kind of pink, which is an issue, but you can see this is very blue, this is very orange. So it's finding that in between. And it's interesting, I found if you go back to auto like that, it keeps it wonky. So if you get really to a point where you can't get it looking at all what you like, you can't always restore default and kind of start over fresh and take another stab at it. That does mean you'll have to set focus again, but sometimes I have found that I can't quite get the settings back to what I wanted, that it gets too far off, and it's good to start over. I hope this has been helpful. This is a tutorial on the different advanced settings, and it should be very useful for your business, for what you're doing. There are so many uses for small business. You can be hosting webinars, you can be on social media, Facebook Live, you can be FaceTiming or Skyping. So having this set up in a somewhat pleasing way is very helpful for that. Anyway, that is everything for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one.